Okay, I am at Quakertown, and I am going to this little Halloween thing they got going on, and I'm going to go down this way. So we shall see. So the kid already said the earth is flat. It doesn't look like a very big thing. I'm in Quakertown and it's right behind, that's the library right there. So I'm right behind the library. This is called the 4th Street Park. Now, this is really dumb because you know what? They could have opened this all up for parking. They really don't think too much, do they? I put my coat on. How's it look? Yeah, it's still recording. And I wondered why the straps kept getting in the way. So I don't know. I guess I'll find a place. Scarecrow, children wristbands. How you doing? That's what I'm doing. Did you ever hear about it?
No.
Yeah, I just show people what it's all about. Hi guys.
Hello, how you doing?
Okay. I'm just doing my free speech thing. That's what I'm handing out if anybody's interested. Yeah, did you ever hear about it?
I've got to unlearn everything I knew.
Yeah, well, you know. Look at here. This is reality, right? You get a line of reflection.
Yep.
Well, that means that it's a flat surface. If it was a curved surface, you'd only get a spot.
So you really believe this, huh?
No, I know it.
You know it?
Yeah, I know it. See, the other thing is that the horizon's always at your eye level.
I have to tell you this, but you're dead wrong.
Yeah, horizon's always at your eye level. See, I'm 63 years old. I'll be 64 in a month. Okay, so 61 years I believed the spinning ball. And I looked into it. My dad was a math teacher, my son physics major. So it had to go through me somewhere, right? So the horizon's always at your eye level. That means it's two planes coming together. It's not a ball. It never goes down.
So after 12 miles, when you get the curve, what do you see after that?
After 12 miles? Why do you say 12?
12 miles is where you get the curve on the arc. So when you're on a ship, like a cruiser?
Actually, what happens is perspective prevents you from seeing any further. Because your eyes, you know these railroad tracks continue.
Yep.
But they come together because that's the way your eyes work. See, so it's not a matter of curve. It's a matter of you can't see farther than that. There's also two other things. Did you ever drive in a fog?
Once in a while.
Yeah, so the fog, if you stretch that moisture out, you can't see through it. Even if it's at a distance, you know, it doesn't look like it, but there's still moisture in the atmosphere. The other thing is angular resolution. So if I'm standing here, I can't read what this says. But if I come out here, I can read it. Do you ever see like the waves on a hot road?
Mm-hmm.
That's the other thing. Over the ocean and things, that happens. So those are three things that you can't see real far. But if you get like a P1000 camera, you can zoom in 60 miles over Lake Michigan and see Chicago. There's a lot of evidence to this. On the back there, there's the videos, you type them in. You get the 200 proofs video, and then you can see all the evidence. Like here's number 71. And then you can think about all those evidences and then decide for yourself.
I have to look into that.
Yeah,
that's
because it's a very good study. Makes you smart, even if you don't accept it, makes you smarter.
Okay.
Thank you, dear. Well, if you come and ask me, are you allowed to talk to me? Where's your mom and dad?
In China.
They're in China?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll tell you a couple of things, all right? And you can take this home and show them. Okay, you want to show them? You have a pocket? No, you don't have a pocket, do you?
I don't care.
He'll hold it for you. Here, you hold it for him. Okay. So look, when you have a sunset, the reflection on the water is a line, like that. That's a line, right?
Yeah.
But if it was a curve, you'd only get like a spot. So now you can go down the ocean and watch. Is it really a line or is it a spot? Then you can decide for yourself.
But how about when they go up into space, why is it a ball?
Well, guess what? They're putting up fake pictures. They put up fake pictures. You have to decide if it's true or not. You can't believe things you see on television.
But why would we believe this? Why would we believe this then?
Yeah, why would we
believe this? I'm not telling you to believe it. You don't have to believe it. You have to figure it out. It's like a puzzle. You got to figure it out.
What do you think?
I think it's this.
Flat?
Yeah. But you got to figure it out. See?
Well, we couldn't see anything when we were at the ocean except water.
Well, you got to look. Is there a line? Does it reflect in a line?
Yeah.
Well, then maybe that's evidence that it's flat. You got to figure it out.
That's sad.
Yeah, that's sad.
Well, just don't believe everything everybody tells you. You got to study.
I'm going to beat NASA up. They take pictures and I say, there's a circle.
That's right. You got to question it all. You got to ask those questions.
Let's go.
How about this? If I go ask the cop, what do you think he'll say?
You go up and scare him?
No. Bam.
Go scare him.
I have a question.
See? You gotta study. You gotta study.
The earth is flat!
Oh my. I'm good, how are you?
Good. So I was just made aware, I guess everybody here had to fill out an application to be here today.
Oh.
Yeah, which so.
Application?
Uh-huh.
Like for what?
To be here today.
Like a vendor?
Yeah.
Or
all the vendors had to fill out
okay.
An application.
Okay, yeah, I'm not a vendor.
Well, that's all that's allowed here today.
No, it's not, though.
Yeah, so everybody here had to fill out an application.
See, I'm here under free speech. That's what I'm here under. I don't sell anything. You can have this. I don't sell anything. I'm not... I just share scientific evidence and let people decide for themselves.
Okay. Well, the people that are running this today,
Yeah, I know. But this is a public park.
And well, this is a private event, though.
I know. Mm-hmm. It doesn't matter. It's on public ground, and wherever there's a public square where people gather, then you can't, like, do that. You can't shut it off. You can ask your supervisor.
We already have.
But I already got the law here.
Mm-hmm. Well,
It's federal.
We already have, ma'am. I'm going to have to ask you to leave.
I would like to speak for your supervisor.
Well, he's not here at the moment.
I know that. But I have that right to have your supervisor.
Well, I'll have the girl that's running this talk to you.
I'll talk to her too.
Hi.
How are you?
Good, how are you?
Okay.
My name's Ashton. I'm in the Borough Parks and Rec. We require all vendors to fill out an application with us in order to come. We don't allow groups to just show up.
Right.
We're affiliated with a lot of groups, and if we allowed everyone to just show up and hand out pamphlets, we'd be inundated with it. So the borough has a policy that we don't allow.
Yeah.
I hear everything that you're saying.
Okay. And I've really met a lot of this same thing before.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm not here as a vendor. I just am here on a free speech issue.
But it's a community event, so we're technically renting out the park.
Yeah, I know.
So
and
it's not
can't
just
do
open
that.
To random.
I mean, it's a public park.
I mean, we can do this the easy way.
Now I get the threat. Yeah, I know.
We don't want to be escorting you out of here.
Well, the thing is, I have the right to be here, though.
You can't shut it off.
The borough has a policy on it, though. It's the borough.
Yeah, but this is federal law. It's federal law. It's a public space. The public is gathering. It doesn't matter if you rent it out or not.
But if we're making vendors purchase.
I'm not a vendor. I'm an individual.
We only allow vendors.
But I'm an individual here.
But you're handing out pamphlets, which makes you a vendor.
No. No,
yes,
oh, look, it says, I have the right to pass out literature. I have the right to exercise religion. We have a guaranteed access to streets and other traditional public forums. Okay? Freedom of speech may not be prohibited merely because it offends someone. I don't need a permit down here, Marsh versus Alabama. I don't need a permit. And there's also another
Ma'am,
one.
I'm just asking you just politely just to leave at this point.
Well, I know, but you can't do that, see? Because
yes,
I'm here under free speech. You know, you can say it, but that doesn't mean you can make me leave.
I mean, we have borough ordinances.
I know, but this is federal. This is federal, which supersedes all of everything.
Well, you have to understand each borough and township can enforce their own ordinances.
But they can't supersede the federal law.
We have our ordinances that you have.
I know, and that's all you seem to know. See, and I'm showing you that you can have this and study it. And you look up these cases.
Right now, we're just asking you politely to leave.
I know you're doing that. But I can't do that under federal law. I have the right to be here.
Well, if I call my supervisor over here and you don't leave, we're going to have to escort you out of here.
I'll call the borough manager.
Yeah.
I'm gonna call it. What's your name, ma'am?
Marilyn Spirit Level.
Okay.
You can look right there at the bottom. You can have one of these.
Oh, I'm good.
Oh, well, that's my information. You don't want my information?
I just wanted your name.
Oh. Earth is not a spinning ball. I mean, I don't have miss. I don't have to be, like, walking around, like, in the middle of things. I don't have to do that. I can
the issue is that there's it's a vendor event. It's not, we don't allow groups to just show up.
I'm not a group. This is a free speech issue. That's all. I just share information.
I know, but we don't allow people to just
And you think you can do that. You think you have the right to do that.
It's the borough ordinance.
No, but this is federal law.
I get that. See, but this is a private event.
If you know that you're infringing on my free speech rights, would you really want to do that?
I don't, you can go to the street. You don't have to be right in the middle of the children's event.
But this is public... public space.
But it's a borough event.
I understand that.
Well, he's talking to the manager, so whatever they...
Okay. All right.
I mean, I'm not going to try and ruin your event in any way. I could stand right over there. I just want it to be open to people who want to see it. Here we go. See, these people think that they don't have to follow the law. I mean, they think that they can just do what they want. I don't understand. Now, where's he going? Is he going to go get the dog? Is he getting the dog? Getting the dog? Is he going to get the dog to frighten me? Is that what he's doing? He went to get the dog to frighten me? Is that what he's doing?
What's going to happen? I'm going to ask you politely one more time to leave. If you don't leave, I'm going to have to trespass you.
Holy cow.
Unfortunately.
So where is the event? Where does your event end?
What do you mean?
Where is the line?
This whole park, so out the very front of the highway.
Out on the street. So this is not public ground.
If you go through those barricades, it would be out past those barricades. I would say it's safe for the event.
So if I don't leave, now let me get this right. If I don't leave, then you are going to arrest me for trespassing.
No, if you don't, I'm just asking you plainly to leave right
now. No, I want you to say what's going to happen. If I don't leave, are you going to arrest me for trespassing?
Well, I will trespass you if you do not
leave. No. Are you going to arrest me for trespassing if I don't leave?
If you eventually do not leave after being warned,
speak
yes.
Speak it. No. Right now. Are you warning me to leave?
I am warning you to leave.
Are you going to arrest me if I don't leave?
Correct.
Say yes or no.
Yes.
Okay, then you are going to have something following this.
Okay.
Okay?
Yes.
Because I have the right to sue you now.
Okay.
The earth is flat.
It's had to like, sorry.
No problem. All right, now what am I going to say to you about this? All this crap. It is evil. Evil. Now, I didn't get the guy's badge name, badge number. Maybe I should go back and get that. Wasn't in the mood to get arrested again. Just wasn't in the mood for it. So. We can pray for rain, that this event gets rained out. So I gotta find out if just the threat of arrest is enough, because he was backing out of that. You know what? I wish we were all doing this and not just me. How do you brainwash a nation? Tell them we live on a spinning globe. Get the kids when they're little. All right, now what's happening here? I'm gonna go home because I just... Yes, do I know the Freemasons are running this and they're just like, they're so evil? Yeah. That dumb young kid, punk. Oh, man. Okay, that's it. Not going to film anymore today. I'm going to try and get someplace tomorrow and hit a good event tomorrow. It's cold. I know, I'm coming up with the excuses now, but I'm telling you. All right, guys, sorry. Talk to you later.